We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Hey, Anika Denise is here, author of Baking Day at Grandma's. Today, you've come to the right place. Grandma Rosie's chocolate cake. What is better on a day like this, especially before the holidays, but this? And you're ready to cook this up for us, right?
Oh, yes.
You're going to bake this up. Now, just give us a little background on this, because this was your grandmother?
Yes.
Your grandmother. Okay. Mm-hmm. And she put a recipe book together. And I know a lot of people will understand, because there's a recipe book that she made for everyone. Mm-hmm. And this woman was like really... She was on it. She wrote letters in the beginning of the book. She typed everything up. There's pictures here that we'll show later. For you, it's got to be nice to be able to look back and see all of these memories.
It is. I love opening up the book, seeing pictures of my grandmother, seeing her handwriting. You know, it brings me back to cooking with her.
The recipe we're making today, this is one of her famous recipes?
Absolutely. Her signature cake.
Okay. So, and what makes it so special?
Well, it's really easy to put together.
Oh, good.
And it tastes absolutely delicious, and it's sort of foolproof, and
okay.
It's impressive when you taste it.
Right.
Really rich in flavor, yummy, light.
And I like that. All right, let's go over the ingredients for anyone out there who wants to make the cake. Tell
okay.
us what we need.
Okay, so you need a cup of flour,
mm-hmm.
Any flour.
Yep.
A cup of sugar and a half cup of cocoa.
Okay, that's really going to give it the rich
yes.
flavor that's in it.
I like to use the dark chocolate
oh
cocoa.
Oh my God, so do I. I love dark chocolate.
Dark chocolate cake, and it actually gives it a really nice dark color and a really rich, deep flavor.
Okay.
We've got one egg,
mm-hmm.
Some sliced butter. We're going to do a little bit with the butter, pouring some boiling water over the butter. You'll see that in a little bit. With some baking soda here, and a pinch of salt. And some vanilla, and
you are good to go.
Yep.
You're good to go. All right, so we are going to put this together. We're also going to talk about, the book that's out that you can purchase. Also, we're going to go through some of the recipes in here and show you how efficient this lady was. She had everything typed up, passed it out to everybody, and we are going to get to it and make this famous cake. And yes, if you're lucky enough, we're going to try it anyway. Back to you.
Yeah, that's right. I'm with Anika Denise. She is the author of Baking Day at Grandma's, a great gift that you should certainly add under the tree this year. And there's a recipe
mm-hmm.
in the back of it.
Yes.
I love that idea. And we're making the recipe today. It's for chocolate cake.
Yes.
We're making them into cupcakes.
We're adapting them into mini cupcakes because
okay.
this time of year it's really fun to give, you know, food gifts and share. So, and that's
yeah.
what the little bears in the book do. So we're going to make mini cupcakes. So
great.
First step is we just put in our three main dry ingredients. So the cocoa,
okay.
cup of cocoa, and cup of sugar.
Great.
And flour.
Beautiful. Did you have to sift the flour beforehand?
No, you don't have to sift it. That's what's so great. This is such an easy recipe. And so we just want to stir that up.
Okay.
Get it so we kind of makes it all dark. And while
why is it important to incorporate the dry ingredients separate from the wet ingredients?
Well, when we add, we'll see what we're going to do. We're going to make a little place to put the butter.
Okay.
You want these nice and well blended because it actually just helps with the consistency of the cake.
Beautiful.
And then we're going to make, that looks about done.
Okay.
And then we're going to take, this is the part my kids really enjoy. You make a little place to put the butter. Like you hollow out this little...
Like you would with mashed potatoes
yes.
and the gravy.
Yes. So then you add your butter in this little nice sort of moat.
Okay.
Okay. The butter is slices. It's half a stick of butter.
Mm-hmm.
You want me to do that?
Sure.
Okay.
Have you let that sit for a little
you
while?
You know, because we're going to be pouring the boiling water over it, you don't even need to soften the butter.
Oh, you're going
to
boil the water. Okay.
Yeah. So this is boiling here. This is also another fun part. So you make like a little... It's like you tuck them in there.
Tower.
Yeah, this is why the kids like this part, because they can help with that.
Mm-hmm.
And then you take your boiling water, which is here. Let's turn that off so it's not at a boil. And then you're going to add your baking powder, and it kind of does a little poof-up thing.
Okay.
Okay. Go ahead, toss it right in. In the water. Yep.
Woo!
Okay,
science.
And as that's science, yes. It's a book and a math lesson and a science lesson. Okay, so then you just pour that over, and it melts the butter.
What a great tip.
And actually, the reason why you do that, because I didn't know for years why you did that, but the heat acts as a leavening with your baking powder,
mm-hmm.
and that makes a nice, light consistency to the cupcake. To the
and
cake.
Then a couple other things quickly that we're going to
yep.
be adding an
we're
egg.
We're going to do our egg.
What else do we need here?
And our vanilla.
Okay. So I will stir that.
And then you start mixing it up.
We're getting that going. Oh my gosh, it smells so good because it's the hot water and
yeah.
that cocoa, it smells like hot chocolate.
It does.
We're going to finish this recipe when we come back.
Back in the Rhode Show kitchen on this Friday morning, Anika Denise is here, author of Baking Day at Grandma's. We've got Grandma Rosie's chocolate cake, not just any chocolate cake. dark chocolate cake is what's in this too, right?
Yes.
All right, we've got a bunch of stuff. You've already mixed this together, so tell us what we have.
So the batter came together really nicely, and now because we're doing the mini cupcakes, I have this 2-tablespoon scoop, and that really helps to just scoop it in. So you just want to fill each cup, and then we get it in the oven. And I like using the 2-tablespoon scoop because that way each cupcake is about the same size, and then they bake evenly. So.
Okay.
So that works.
And it's not overflowing. So you, well, I'm gonna, I'll, we'll
you're
scoop
gonna
this.
Scoop, putting you to work, Will.
That's okay.
You actually have some too that we're baking, and then you gave them time to cool because anytime you're about to frost a cupcake, please give it ample time.
Yes, you don't want to frost on a warm cupcake because your frosting will melt off the cupcake. But and it's really fun. These, I love this size around the holidays because they make great little food gifts, presents. You can put them in a little baking tin, and they look really nice all frosted. So we're going to...
You bring up a good point about giving them away.
Yes.
You do so much baking around the holidays. You're surrounded by so much good food and sweets, and part of your book, really the true meaning of your book, is about sharing and giving back, and you're actually doing that.
Yes. The little bears in the book, everyone says it's a surprise ending because they don't actually eat the treats that they make with their grandmother. They wrap them up as presents. And so I wanted to take that concept and do something in our community that was charitable. And I read about a Bake It Forward campaign and thought, ooh, that would be really fun to do.
Sure.
So I'm asking people, I live in Barrington, so I'm asking the Barrington community, and they've been great. They really responded to, if you're baking for the holidays, bake an extra batch. And
Make
a couple extra, and we're going to distribute it to people all through the community, to shelters.
That's great.
This weekend.
Is there a time if people at home want to bake a few?
Absolutely. We're still accepting donations. In fact, I have my elves at home taking the baking donations now throughout the weekend. Just contact me, send me an email through my website, AnikaDenise.com, and I will find a home for your baked goods. And
perfect.
We're so happy to have volunteer bakers.
We were also showing your book itself. Your husband did the illustrations in the book.
He did, yes. Yep.
Sam.
He's so impressive, I have to say. I mean, the quality of the pictures in is just so great.
Yes, he went
those
to
cute little bears.
Went to Rhode Island School of Design for illustration, and
he was able to put those together. The other nice thing is you and I were talking before about the original book that your grandmother kind of passed down to everyone. There's pictures in there of her. It's got to give you great joy to be able to open up. Grandma's right there, and all of her recipes are put together. A lot of times too, you know, they would write them on index cards or something else. This woman knew what she was doing.
Oh, yes, yeah.
She was all about it.
This is so organized.
Yeah, it's organized. It really is. You know,
have some things typed up here. Yeah. It's a binder. It's not a book, it's a binder.
Yeah, we all got them. They were a gift one year, and we all got her recipes, which is really a gift that, I mean, it keeps on giving because
trying
the recipes and making them.
And you also said she would love all this attention.
She would. She would think her... Grandma Rosie's chocolate cake is famous, and she would absolutely love this.
All right, so let's decorate something.
Yeah. Okay, so we have this little... I just put some buttercream. I like vanilla buttercream frosting with these.
Who doesn't?
They're really great, so I like to just put it in a little pastry bag versus using the store-bought.
Sure.
One thing I like doing with my kids is baking from scratch, so just kind of, you know, it's not perfect, but you might make little fun little designs on it.
That's the best part, though. Yeah. Get the kids involved.
Yeah.
Have them decorate however they want. Throw some colored sprinkles, which I know you have.
And that you have some colored sprinkles here.
Can we look at the little mini cupcakes that you've already decorated?
Yes. I did those.
Adorable. You've got some wreaths.
So you just want to
drop those on there.
Drop those on. Yep. We had fun. Gorgeous. We had fun with that.
Plus, you figure you have so many sweets around the holidays, it's almost nice to make them miniature because then you can go ahead and taste one of everything.
It's bite size. It's perfect.
And they have...
You have to try.
I just want to make sure that it's...
Okay,
you know,
Will, it's like a munchkin. You just one bite.
I'm going to take this off, give this a try, and it's dark chocolate, too.
Awesome.
It makes it even better.
Thank you so much for joining us. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Sharing your family recipe. Make sure you pick up this book. It is adorable. Add it to your Christmas list this year. If you want this recipe, Will, do they want it? Yes, they do. Head on over to the Rhode Show page, WPRI.com.